what you have there is, as it were, a cancerous cell in the center of the city from which the heroin habit can spread, because there's no evidence that these people are content to keep their habit to themselves. Others are being drawn in. The interesting thing about the boat, standing there and watching it for about 15 minutes before going in, was the number of people passing in and out. It becomes a center. And like any center, others are attracted to it. There can be no question about tolerating any such thing in London. I mean, I represent a Riverside constituency, and the idea that I could go to the people of Putney and say, by the way, we're putting a little barge on the Thames in Putney to which we're going to invite the heroin abusers of London to go and abuse heroin, I mean, is a nonsense. And if I'm not prepared to do it in my own Riverside constituency, how on earth can I expect one of my colleagues to do this?
There seems to be a growing feeling that the heroin addiction is spreading because it is illegal. You are making it, in fact, worse because you are spreading it.
Well, I wasn't aware that there was a call to legalize heroin. If there were to be one, I would regard it as one of the most profoundly depressing developments in British society. Heroin is an extremely destructive drug. It's certainly the case that more people are using heroin today than ever before, and as you know, we are taking measures that we hope will be effective to combat that. But the fact of the matter is that heroin is a killer, and anyone who gets involved in heroin on the belief that, of course, it won't happen to them and they'll be able to kick the habit, it's just something we should try out for a bit of fun on a Saturday night, are embarking on a path that will lead to misery and ruin, and indeed, in many cases, to death. And, you know, there are always people, when some unacceptable proposition is put forward, who say, don't be extreme, don't be hardline against it, let's try and find some compromise, some middle-of-the-road way in which perhaps we can say that really it's all the authorities' fault for being tough on heroin. But I have to say to you categorically that is nonsense, and certainly no responsible minister in my position could do other than utterly condemn the habit of taking heroin and say that the whole of society, not just the government, must be determined to eradicate it.